Hello. Hi friends. My name is Nilesh. This video is the continuation of the Terraform series. So far in this series, we have seen different aspects related to Terraform, how to work with Terraform and how to use Terraform to provision resources on Microsoft Azure. This video, we are going to take a slight detour and look at how to use Terraform if you already have resources created in the Azure infrastructure. So we are looking at how to import the existing resource into Terraform so that going forward, we can manage Terraform using, or we can manage Microsoft Azure resource using Terraform. So I'll continue from where we left last time and let's get started. Now this scenario is very helpful where you might have created resources using, let's say Azure CLI or some other way in which you provision the resource. It could be provisioned using the Azure portal itself, or you might have used the Azure Resource Manager or ARM template or some other infrastructure as code like Pulami, for example. It doesn't matter how you provision the resource. Assume that you already have the resource provisioned. So let me head over to the Microsoft Azure portal, and in here, let's go into the resource group, and you can see here that I have multiple resource group. I'm going to use ACR resource group, which is used to host the Azure Container Registry for me as an example here. And we are going to use this. Now this resource group was provisioned manually using the Azure portal. I went into the portal and I used the wizard to create this particular resource. But I want to manage this going forward using the Terraform. In this case, we still need the provider information, which is used to connect our Microsoft Azure Resource Manager as the provider for creating resources in Terraform or managing resources in Terraform. In here, you can see that there is this subscription ID which is specified. This is one way of specifying the subscription ID, because when we use the plan or import command, Terraform needs to know which subscription we are going to use. And especially importing, it needs to have that information readily available. So we could hard code this information in our provider information or the provider block in the Terraform configuration. The other approach is to use a environment variable, and we can set the environment variable on the command line. And assuming that Terraform is going to be executed as part of your CI/CD pipeline, we could use the environment variable based approach to set variables and use that as part of the pipeline. So let's head over to the terminal and we can set this using the export command, and we can set a variable called as ARM underscore subscription ID. Now I can set the subscription ID to whatever is the ID of my subscription, and that would be exposing my subscription ID to the terminal, or I would be specifying it in clear text. The other approach I could use is I could store the subscription ID into an environment variable. Using this approach, I use the Azure CLI. So let's say I have the subscription ID already imported, and that I can do using the Azure CLI. I can get the subscription ID and I can store it into the subscription ID as a variable. So I can do this saying export, and I can say subscription ID as the variable name is equal to, and then I can use this dollar sign, and that's to store the value of the value of what is given by the Azure CLI, and I can get the Azure list and the subscription of the list of subscriptions, or I can get the complete list of subscriptions, and from there I can get the subscription ID. Using that approach, I can store it inside a variable called as the subscription ID. And then I can create this variable, which is to refer to the resource group. Now in the earlier videos, I had shown how to create a resource group using Terraform, where we had specified the properties for a resource group. In this case, we are going to import the existing resource group into a Terraform variable. We don't need the complete resource group definition. We just need a placeholder to say that the properties of the existing resource needs to be attached to this particular variable or a logical resource named as ACR resource group. And the type of that is going to be the Azure RM resource group. So once we have this placeholder in our Terraform configuration, which I've specified in resource-group.tf file, we can go ahead and use this Terraform import command. So I have put this for the helpful use in the Terraform, or there is this file called as the commands.markdown or MD file. And let's go and set this as a variable subscription ID. This is for me to enhance the experience of working with the terminal and not to expose the subscription ID into the terminal, because the subscription ID is like sensitive information here. And then we can use the Terraform import command. In this case, we are looking at the resource group, which is named as ACR resource group, or of type resource group. And we want to store that values in our Terraform state in the variable, which is logically named as ACR resource group. And then we specify the ID of the resource group. So that is the actual ID of the resource in Microsoft Azure. So if we go into the Azure portal and we look at the ACR resource group here, and under the resource group related settings, if we go into properties, each object has this subscription ID, then the subscription and the resource ID. So we are particularly looking at this particular resource ID, which is the unique identifier for that particular resource. I can copy it here. And again, because these resources are like a sensitive information, I've masked all this using a Chrome extension or Microsoft Edge extension here. That is why we cannot see the exact ID. But if we copy this, this would be copied to the clipboard and we can use that resource ID here. So the resource ID is basically named as ACR resource group, and it's like a fully qualified name for our resource group. So with that, let's go and run this export command. But before we run the export, we still need to run the Terraform init command. So let's go and first initialize our provider by running Terraform init, which is like a prerequisite, which will initialize the provider related information for us, what we have specified in our provider.tf. So in the provider, I've specified the CLI version as less than or equal to 1.9.5, and then the Azure RM version as 4.0.1, which is the latest version, greater than or equal to. So if there is a higher version available than 4.0.1, this init step would actually download the modules or resources for that particular version. Now we are ready to go and import the resource definition into this particular Terraform state. So let's go and run the second command, which is the import command. And we want to have this ACR resource group definition. And as I said, the difference here is we are not specifying the initial properties for a resource group like the location and the name, because the resource group is already created in Microsoft Azure subscription. We are just importing the existing resources here. And once the resource is successfully imported, we can see the import is successful on the command line. We can go back into our Visual Studio code and we can look at the Terraform TF state, where it has gone ahead and got the properties of that. Under the resources, you can see that the resource group is imported here. The name is ACR resource group and all the other attributes which are specified in the subscription has been imported. So with that, we can see that it is very easy to import the existing resource which is created in our subscription to Terraform, and we can manage the state of this going forward. From here on, we can use Terraform to manage the different properties related with this resource group. Now, there is one limitation of this approach using Terraform import, which is it looks at an individual resource. If we have a hierarchy of resources, as of now, this particular import command does not support that. And in one of the future videos, we will see how to use the import in different manner. We will use a different utility to import multiple resources. Like if we have resource group which contains a VM, which contains a virtual network, which contains a subnet and various other resources, how to import all those definitions together. But for now, this demonstration demonstrates an import of single resource. I hope you found this useful. In case you find these videos useful, please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, and do let me know in the comments what other things you would like to see on this channel. Until next time, code with passion and strive for excellence. Thanks for watching this.